In this video, we'll create a task list or a to-do list that you can download from the link provided in the description. I'll help you create this template from scratch so that you can have a base and create your own versions later. So let's look at this particular task list that I've created and look at each and every component of this sheet. What normally would a task list have? It will have the task type. And when I say task type, it would be what is the department or what is the business unit which the task has arrived in. Let's say in this particular case, I have recruitment, sales, training, operations, PR, and procurement. Then you have the task description, which is like what exactly the task is. You put the entire description over here. After that, you have the name of the person to whom the task has been assigned. And here they are. Then it's the date assigned, date on which it was assigned. And then you put a plausible closure date. When do you want this particular task to be closed? Then you put a priority. And in priority, you can have a code red, high, medium, low, whatever you want over here. And the current status, which is not started, work in progress, and completed. And of course, when the task has been completed, you put the closure date here. Then there's a status column. Then there's overdue comments that you need to put in, and then one column that shows you how late is the task actually. Now, if you see in this entire sheet, I have highlighted three columns in green. This is because they've got formulas in there just to keep them safe from being edited. What you can also do is you can format these columns, protect them, and then protect the sheet so that you don't edit them at all. This is a good practice that you can kind of put in your daily use. In the edge column, you'll put an entry only when the task has been closed. So all of these need to be entered, and you'll see that in most of these columns, there's a drop-down list, which is a validation for task type, the person assigned to, priority, and the current status. It's a very good practice to have tables ready for all such validation so that every time you have to add a person, you have to add a department, or you have to add a new priority or status, you can just update that particular table and your validations get updated. So if you see in this particular sheet, I have got one sheet which is the tables. If we go over there, you can see that I have put in the team member names, task type, current task status, and the priority in tables. And as and when I need to add or remove particular entries from here, I can do that. And then in this particular sheet, I have just done data validations and actually called out those particular tables. So once this particular sheet for tables is ready and you don't have to kind of use it regularly, you can just hide it by right-clicking it and selecting the hide from here. Those who are using the Windows version of Excel can use the shortcut Alt-O-H-H to hide a particular tab, and they can use the shortcut Alt-O-H-U to unhide a tab in the Excel sheet. Now let's try to fill in the formulas here in overdue status and the late days, number of days that we want to put in. So let's first of all try to put in the overdue status and the number of days it is overdue. First of all, we need to understand what do we need in this status. We need to know how many days the task is overdue. And before that, we have to make sure that if a task is not there in a particular sheet or if there is no closure date assigned, then it should not reflect any value at all. So what I've done in this particular formula, if you see here, in the status bar, it's if len of E3 is equal to 0, which means that E3 is the plausible closure date. If it is 0, then it will throw a blank value. If it is not, then we'll see what is H3, which is the closure date. And if there is no closure date put in over here, then it should be able to calculate it, which essentially means that if H3 is equal to 0, that is essentially the closure date has not been put in, then it should give me the number of days it is overdue. And how do we put in the number of days overdue? It's simple. You put down today, the formula for today is today, parenthesis open, close, minus E3. E3 is the plausible closure date. So if you subtract it from here, you will get the number of days it is overdue. Like here, all the negative values are indicating that you still have got time on it, and anything which is a value of 0 will indicate that the task is due today. If it's overdue, it will show a
positive value in this particular column. Basis the number of days overdue, we want to now put down the status of that particular task. So we'll put down the formula in this particular status column. Now, first of all, we need to understand that in order to put this status, what are the riders? What are the important things that you need to kind of remove before putting in the status? There are two things essentially. One is that there is no task in a particular row, one. And the second thing is that the task has already been closed. In those two cases, we don't want to put down the status at all. Like if we don't want to look at the closed task at all, we don't want to put down the status as closed. We just want whatever is work in progress. So what we'll do is that we'll first of all put an if formula. And in the if formula, since there are two different functions independent of each other which need to be satisfied, we will put the or function. So it is if or len of A3, which is the first column in which we have put the task type. We will put if the length of this particular column is 0, which essentially is an indicator that there is no task in a row, or len of H3. H3 is your closure date. If the closure date is not equal to 0, which essentially means that your closure date has been entered. So two things. One is either there is no task in this particular row or the closure date has been already put in. We have defined these two OR functions here. If these two cases are satisfied, then we say that we leave this particular status column empty. Right. Now this rider has been identified and we have put in the specific function for it. Now let's take the status from the number of days overdue column. Here we will say simply that if the number of days overdue is equal to 0, then we say that it is due today. If it is less than 0, then yes, there is still time, which indicates a negative value. There is still time. And if it is greater than 0, then we say that it is overdue. This is what I have defined here in this particular nested if function. If J3, which is the overdue days, is equal to 0, then it is due today. If it is greater than 0, it is overdue. And if it is less than 0, then there is still time. So once you have defined this function, you just copy it and paste in the entire column to get the status of each and every task. You can see that all the tasks when we have put in a closure date, they will throw a blank value, which essentially means that the task has been closed. Now in the last column, what we have defined is that a closed task, by how many days is it late from the plausible closure date? Now in order to define it, the only rider here is that there should be a closure date. So what I've done here in this column is that if len of H3, which is the closure date, is equal to 0, then you leave it blank, else you do plausible closure date minus the closure date. That should give you the number of days the task is late. See, all the closed tasks here, they are showing the days by which they are late. Now I have my master task list ready, and every time we have a meeting with the team members, we'll just look at those tasks and change the status wherever required, add new tasks whenever it is required, and of course see how much late a task is, what is due, what is overdue, which is the task that needs to be focused on. But let us not limit our task list to just this weird looking task tracker. Let's make a dashboard out of it. So if you see in the next tab here, there's a proper dashboard here. Let's talk about this dashboard in detail. Don't worry, it's a simple dashboard that I've built with simple formulas used over here. Each and every kind of report, a mini report that you can see over here, is very easy to make. I have made a few of those reports. You can work on your own to see what kind of reports you need and highlight them over here. Now, if you see there's a particular border over here, it's no fancy border. It's just two columns, one colored in black and one in gray, and I've just decreased the size. And let's look at these dashboards, these small statuses one by one, how I have arrived at these. As I said, these are not hard and fast that you need to use only these particular reports. You can make or think about reports on your own. This is just a starting point for you. So if you look at the first report, it is priority versus the task status. It has got the priority on one axis of the report and the task status of the tasks on another axis. How can I get these reports? The simplest way to do it is the count function. And since we have two different things to count, we will use the count if s function. So as you see here, let's go to the first cell over here, which is code red and not started. Okay, now just to make you understand how to put down formulas in this particular report, an individual report, let me just remove the formulas of one report altogether and try to put the formula in one cell first. Count if s bracket start. And by the way, if I have not told you already, the formula or the function that you put in is not case sensitive at all. So if you're working in lowercase, it will still work. It will automatically take it as an uppercase. Okay, coming back here, it's count if s. And now we want to take the priority range as our first criteria range. So we'll go to come down here, click on to-do list, select the priority column entirely, which is F, comma, click back on the dashboard tab, select the heading over here in D7, comma, then we want to select the task status, so we go back to the to-do list, we select the current status column, comma, we go back to the dashboard and click on E6, which is the heading for the status for this particular cell. We close the parenthesis and enter. Now if you just try to copy this particular cell and paste it in the entire region, it will not give you the correct values, because with every change in the cell, the reference is also changing. But we want to keep the reference constant. Like say here we had the reference of the to-do list F column. In this particular one, it will go to G and so on. So what we'll need to do is that we'll first need to fix the references over here. So what we'll do is that first of all, the first criteria range, we know that it will remain constant. So we'll put a dollar against F here and F here. Then dashboard D7 is this particular column. All the priorities are listed in a column, which essentially means that your column will remain the same, but with every change in cell or row, the row number should change. So what we'll do is that here in this criteria, we'll put a dollar before D. Now we go to the second criteria range. We put a dollar before G here and here as well. And we see that dashboard E6. Now the task status is in a particular row and we want this row to be constant irrespective of the cell chain. So what we'll do is that we'll leave E to change, the column to change, and the row number we'll put a dollar before it so that it becomes constant. Now you enter, and now what you can do is you can copy this cell and paste in the entire range. Now see, you get the exact status and you didn't have to put in formulas in each and every cell independently. Now based on your requirement, you can add more reports over here. Like I've got one report for priority versus deadline. So I have the priority over here in this particular axis, and then the status, whether it's overdue, due today, in this particular axis. Now I want to make sure that any particular thing which is code red should never be overdue. I know that here I have got one task which is overdue, so it's a problem for me. I will go to that particular task and see what's happening over there and try to contact my team and get it done. Similarly, I'll also look at this particular thing which is due today. Now out of the ones which are due today, I can see that four tasks are of a priority level high, which are the ones that I need to look at. Similarly, I can have a report which is department wise and see in each and every department how many high priority tasks I have, how many code red I have, and so on. Then I can look at the person-wise priority as well to see who is performing, who has got how many tasks, and how are my team members working. Do I need to assign them more tasks or not? And then I can also look at the schedule fidelity of my team members to see like how many tasks have they kind of delivered in time, how many tasks are overdue, how many tasks they still have time. As I said, there are many, many reports that you can think of and put in this particular dashboard based on upon your requirement, and then track them as required. Now, for each and every report in the dashboard, you can also prepare a chart or a graph. We know that graphs are more interactive. You get to see your data. The visualization is good. So let's try to see if we can make some graphs over here. Let me select the first data over here. I go to insert and insert a chart, or in the ribbon, I select the chart and then select the chart type. Let's say I select the column, a clustered column over here, and I get this particular chart. So basically, I can then prepare charts for each and every particular report in the dashboard and have a visualization ready for me. What I've done is that I have prepared a separate tab for charts, and at any point of time, if you don't want to look at the reports, you can directly go over here and see the different charts over here to see what's happening with the tasks. Like I got overall progress of tasks, then I got tasks in progress by priority, priority versus the status, priority versus deadline, task type, person-wise priority, schedule fidelity. So all the reports, I converted them to charts. The visualization is really good over here. Now you can see that from a simple to-do list, we can create an entire dashboard, which can be handy. You can download this particular dashboard, this particular task tracker from the link given in the description. If you have any better ideas for task lists, do share with me, and we can get them implemented as well in our next videos.